you've been taught, you have mental associations because of the kind of culture we were all brought up in, if you were brought up in Western culture, that discipline is a bad thing. It refers to, you have a negative association, it refers to kind of being in prison, being in jail, forcing yourself to do something you actually don't want to do, or some outside agency, some outside source kind of making you do something that if it was totally up to you, you would never choose to do. That's not discipline, that's forcing you. Discipline is the actual way to, and all of us have to cultivate it, learn it, it's not automatic, is the actual way to have the ability to do what you want to do when you want to do it. So discipline means you have the willpower, you have the capacity, you have the strength to do things you choose, even feel things you choose, that your conditioning may be against, not want, that your ego may not like, that your thought process may be unhappy with, that your emotional level may reject, but you want it.
Yeah. Yeah, so I don't have that.
So, you, like most of us, almost all of us, those few who have mastered the art of self-discipline are few and far between. So you're in the vast majority, don't think you're a special case, but how we got on the subject of discipline in the first place in the mystery school curriculum class meeting where it came up is because we were talking about freedom. There is no possibility of ultimate freedom for a human being, ultimate spiritual attainment. There is no possibility of it whatsoever unless, in other words, the real endpoint. Lots of things are possible and happen and are wonderful and are desirable before the end point. But when we're talking about a very advanced point, you cannot get to where you're trying to go ultimately without cultivating and learning the art of self-discipline. Because only a disciplined mind can actually achieve ultimate freedom. And that's just the wiring of it. That's just the way it is. But any increase in your ability for discipline benefits you exponentially. So you don't even have to have the end goal in mind. And you can simply accept or understand that any increase in your capacity for discipline with yourself has tremendous benefits. Ultimately, discipline is about controlling your own mind, not being at the mercy of your thought process, which is absolutely controlled by the dictator called ego. So the simplest, most real and ultimate answer to, well, what is discipline anyway? It's the road to freedom. It's the method for absolute freedom. And along the way, before it's absolute, before it's the whole enchilada, any increase in ability for self-discipline is an increase in, is a exponential increase in freedom. Because freedom isn't freedom for yourself, and it isn't freedom of yourself, it's freedom from yourself.